Hi, my name is Partho Sen Gupta. This is my second film in the India Gold section. It's called Sunrise, Arunoday. It's an Indo-French co-production. I have a long journey because I'm almost 50 years old, and I started when I was 17. So I didn't really have, I only had formal education in cinema later in my life, and when I was in my late 20s. I think that for me, what I really have learned is that, you know, I keep my eyes open and I try to talk less when I'm, you know, that's how I learned the most. I started in Bollywood. I mean, I started as an apprentice with Bijon Das Gupta, who's a very big art director. So I started in Sagar, and I worked in Mr. India and, you know, Dharam Arkan and all the big films in the kind of 80s. But then slowly when I started to work on my own as an art director, I started working in parallel cinema. So I worked with Sudhir Mishra. I was the art director of Raak by Aditya Bhattacharya, which I think was a film made too early in Indian film history. I think that film festivals play a very important role in educating people about the different types of cinema. I mean, at least that's what their role was in the past. As film festivals, as the market gets more and more, once upon a time the market rejected the film festivals. They would not sort of participate in the film festival. So it was very clear there was the market, and, you know, professional cinema, or what they called, you know, mainstream cinema, and there was a parallel cinema which needed festivals to show. But I think since sort of disinvestment from the state in festivals, and the market now participating in running the festivals, I think the choice of what festivals choose has changed. It has changed because it has somewhere to please the market, because since the market now participates in the festival. Curators in festivals, despite all the pressure, still fight and try to get films that will never be seen into the festivals, and try to seek, you know, give them some kind of platform so that they can meet maybe some kind of distribution, maybe because it achieves a certain notoriety in the festival circuit that some niche distributors decide to buy them, you know. So yes, I think that's a very important role, and festivals should keep that that curation of, you know, difficult films. I want to use the word difficult films, where certain filmmakers who try to experiment or try to push the lines of what is accepted as cinema, you know. To me, somewhere the stories I want to tell are take place in Mumbai. They are, you know, it's my city. I'm linked to this city, and every time I finish a film, because it gets more and more difficult to shoot films in Mumbai, you know, it's difficult to get permissions, difficult to shoot on the street, and I always say that, okay, this is it. I'm never going to shoot again in Mumbai. And the moment it gets over, I'd say, okay, maybe one more film in Mumbai, and then I'll never shoot again in Mumbai. I didn't think of any target audience because, you know, I'm making a certain kind of parallel cinema, and there is no target audience in the parallel cinema. It's my desire to make a certain film in a certain style, and maybe push boundaries, you know, push boundaries from what is available around me, because I'm free to do it, and that's the only space I can do it. So that's what I would like to tell people, you know, you people, young people from film schools, that till you get into the market, I mean, just try to experiment and try to make films the way you want to make it. And even if it's not acceptable to your peer group as a style, but if you feel it's right, then you should do it, because, you know, you're all artists, and you must, you know, keep that idea that you're an artist.